unconventional. The one word that I can consistently use for every Harris chain experience I've had. You know, Harris chain, every time we go there, there's big fields. Harris chain does not handle pressure very well. There's only a few places that really have populations of fish, population centers offshore, the way I like to fish, that allow for competing in these tournaments at the weights that they take. And so in the places that I find, usually I end up fishing around large crowds and have to fish a little bit differently. This event took a really different approach to fishing some very conventional places, some community holes. I just went community hole fishing this tournament and ended up catching a really good bag. So stay with us. There's going to be a lot of fish catching action. So I hope you guys are looking forward to it.
Out and touch him, boss.
That's where we found her. Close to.
Close to.
Nah, 2.5. Heck yeah. Heck yeah, Fields. Good work on the net, though. 2.5 pounder.
Yeah.
Woo. Good start. Not mad. Not mad.
It's a 5 pounder. Heck yeah.
We're gonna make it happen today, boss.
Which whale?
Two more of those.
Which whale?
I'll put it in the middle. Dude, I told you those were big ones.
Dude, that was so damn.
I saw him go down, and I had to go tunk, and I went, uh-oh. Hey, Phil. Hey, Phil.
I've been wanting to see you catch one on that. That'll work.
Now you have. We'll be right back.
saw him go nose down on it and then dunk. That was a mistake, fishy. That was a mistake you just made, my friend.
Keep him down. Keep him down.
Ah, he's not that good, but he's a keeper. He'll fill the limit. Ah, he's better than that. Oh.
Super tiny.
No, that one's fun. That's a 2-pounder.
Yeah.
You got 11 pounds now.
Yeah.
That ain't a joke, man.
About the same for us, too. 2 pounds,
you put the poles down.
Florida Giant.
He's stuck in the field. We'll put him on the little side.
Yeah.
Hey, we got 5. 11 pounds. We need some more.
I catched it in a bag.
Two more of those and a 4-pounder. Be hard to not qualify.
That's a cold. You think so? He ain't worth pulling on.
I mean, it's not. Brings us to about 14 and a half pounds.
Yep.
I'm glad I hooked that one because I couldn't tell if he was good or not. And that one would have haunted me if I didn't. Because he was just big enough that he looked decent.
Yeah.
It's a little cold.
Yeah, sweet.
Fish just need a big one. Another big one. And another big one. And another big one.
I'm gonna call all of them. Not an impounder, but
on the swim
bait.
That one should help,
shouldn't
it?
Yeah, it will. Let me reel mine up. I'll take yours off first. That was pale. You didn't need no trailer for
fun. Wait, let me see. Okay, good. Maybe you took some time.
No, it ain't. Bad enough to where it'll kill him.
Hmm?
It ain't bad enough to where it'll kill him.
No, he's just in the gills.
Here you go, sir. Turn it over. That's in that.
Yes.
Good work, man. High three. Let's catch a couple more of those.
No. I'll set it down.
He's not quite four, but he's close. That's a call, boss. 2 pounds. That puts him like almost 16.
Get your stuff done. I'll get this.
All right. What's our smallest?
2 pounds.
Top 10, boss.
All right. Like, great big.
Yeah, like big.
Hey, we're doubled up.
What do you got?
I got a big.
Big?
Yeah.
This one might be my chance at the top 10.
Let's go!
Not quite 6, it's 4.
Hey, Fields.
Yep.
How about that? Yep. That's a championship guarantee. 4-pounder, bud! There we go! All right. That's what I'm talking about!
Let me cool.
Woo!
I'll do this one.
You fish, yeah. Your drop shot. Which side would our small be on?
That one.
I'm gonna catch me a couple more of those, and we're gonna. I thought that one was huge, dude. He was dogging me. At first, I thought he looked about 4, but then he just started zinging my drag. I was like, that's gotta be bigger than 4. It wasn't. But guess what? 4-pounder? Not mad about it. Then we got. Heck yeah, Chad. Back up on the front deck and chase it down.
You ready?
Yep. He's this way.
And then the one you have to go over the boat. Not bad, though.
Cool. High 4. Another one like that.
He's close if he's not.
He won't get this net out of here without hitting me.
Bad test. Just get there a little.
I'm trying to take a picture now. I'm sorry. I wasn't ready.
I mean, these are beautiful. The colors on these are beautiful.
Yeah, I agree. I need to get my flops.
Gill. Those will do.
I mean, they're okay. Yeah.
Roll that side.
Hope that.
Roll that side and make it a little later. Nice. Evan, you might help me with this.
Yep, gotcha. Hold on.
Drew Gill, Evan Fields. Today's weight's going to be 19 pounds and 3 ounces. Going to be a 7th place finish for Drew and Evan. Hold them up, guys. Hold them up. Good job. Now, I will say Drew Gill will be out of commission after how many events, Coach? 4 events, right? After 4. Go to your right. You've done this before. Come on, man. Drew Gill right there holding them up. He's going to be fishing the Tackle Warehouse Invitationals. I'll be running those as well. I'm running the high school, college, and Tackle Warehouse Invitationals, and I'll be running that event down at Toho. So, unfortunately, Drew, you'll have to be on the stage with me a lot, unfortunately. Go over here, talk with me, man, on that microphone. I know you're excited about Okeechobee here in a little while, but let's talk about this, man. You just qualified for the national championship again.
Yeah, Yeah, this was, man, it was a great event today. Uh-huh. Everything went the way I could have wanted it to go and got the chance to qualify for another championship. So absolutely. I couldn't be happier.
And I see here, Coach, I know you guys hate to lose Drew, but that's what you're recruiting him for, is to represent Campbellsville, and here you're going to another championship. Congratulations.
Thank you,
Kevin. Well done, man. Great job.
Mess, but it's worthwhile. Worthwhile mess, because we just got a top 10 ball.
That's right.
Hey, first qualification.
All the fish that me and Evan weighed came on a 7.6 medium light fast Arc Invoker Pro spinning rod with the Daiwa Ballistic 2500 LT spinning reel. What a great combo for fighting fish on small hooks and small line. The drag is buttery smooth. The rod allows for making really long casts with really small baits. I was using a really, really light technique at this tournament. And that 7.6 just, it allows you to put it out there really far. It's really convenient for that. Fought fish really well around cover, around shallow water with fish that are taking a lot of runs because they can't have up and down to work with. And so that rod and that reel performed beautifully for what I needed it to in this tournament. Caught 19.3 and finished 10th in this event. So couldn't have been happier. It was my one chance to qualify for the MLF championship this year, the MLF College Championship. Due to eligibility rules, you know, relating to my invitational schedule, I was only able to fish one event this season because the two others that I could have fished just did not line up with my schedule. And I wasn't eligible after May, after my fourth invitational, after your fourth pro event. You're no longer eligible for MLF college tournaments. So this was my one chance to qualify for the championship, and I was able to get it done. And I, you know, couldn't have asked for a better tournament. Lost one that would have mattered, but when you get a top 10 and losing one that doesn't cost you the win in a tournament with no points, you don't really beat yourself up about it too bad. Couldn't have been more grateful for this event. Me and Evan had a lot of fun this week. One of the more fun weeks I've had on the Harris chain for sure. Caught a lot of fish, and I hope you guys are looking forward to the next tournament because it is the second invitational of the year. It's at Clark's Hill. Pretty excited to put in this video out. It's a big learning curve for me this season, fishing the style that the invitationals have been fishing the last two events and will be fishing the rest of the season. There's a lot to learn. And this one was a big learning experience for me. So I hope you guys are excited to watch that one. I'm ready to put it out. I hope you guys have a good day, and thank you for watching.